1 pound over the stipulated weight limit of 111. As a result of that, he's going to have to wear 8-ounce gloves. That's going to be a disadvantage. This young boy didn't want to reduce, decided to take the odds, and we've been told that he's fighting with 8-ounce gloves. So that's a disadvantage. If you're a quick fighter, got quick hands, heavier weight, harder to hit.
That's right. And not only that, takes a little bit of sting of your punches, because
exactly.
As you wear heavier gloves, then your punches have less of an impact when they land on your opponent. Now, Tore Campo is a slugger.
Both tough boys.
Yes. Tore Campo, as we mentioned at the top of our coverage, has scored brilliant knockouts here on Blow by Blow, stopping the previously unbeaten Reynan Terrojo and Marvin Corpus. Here we go, Tore Campo.
Walking to the body. Tore Campo in blue, Pacquiao in white. Pacquiao, very definitely a height and reach advantage. But Tore Campo has come to fight, and he's come to slug it out. I mean, he's not concerned about the reputation of the unbeaten Manny Pacquiao. Tore Campo really going after Pacquiao early in this fight. Working to the body.
Well, I think Tore Campo wants to deliver a statement here to Manny Pacquiao that he is not at all fazed by the reputation of the unbeaten fighter. It's been Tore Campo from the start smoking.
Actually, Pacquiao might have a rude awakening in this fight.
Tore Campo is a big puncher.
And Pacquiao connects with the left from under.
And one thing about Manny Pacquiao, he really has not been tested.
He's not been really tested.
Yeah, that's right. He really has faced a hard puncher.
They tie each other up. Tore Campo setting the pace early in this fight.
Yes. Now we are scheduled for 10. Tore Campo being very, very
active. He caught Pacquiao with a good left.
Of course, you raised the question whether Tore Campo can keep this blistering pace to the end. That is, of course, if Manny Pacquiao survives.
Pacquiao with a good flurry of punches that time. But as I said, the heavier gloves are not going to help him when it comes to punching. He goes after Tore Campo. Beautiful right uppercut by Pacquiao. And the crowd's on its feet. He goes after Tore Campo. They're really slugging it out there. Tore Campo connects with the hard right. Pacquiao with the left from under. This fight won't go 10 rounds.
Well, the way it's going, Manny Pacquiao looking also for a quick knockout.
Yes.
Here.
I mean, I think he's being angered, and he thinks that, you know, he's left. Oh, beautiful left by Pacquiao. Flush on the face of Tore Campo. That was a big punch. Uppercut by Pacquiao.
Pacquiao's moving in Tore Campo. I mean, this is a slugfest.
Campo, beautiful looping right and left by Pacquiao.
Tore Campo.
Cracking right by Pacquiao again. What a fight. What a fight.
Well, Pacquiao showing better defense, better footwork than Tore Campo.
That was the bell. Rip roaring round. The bell for round number two. Manny Pacquiao in the white trunks with the red stars and stripes down the side. Against hard-hitting Rustico Tore Campo in blue. And the first round has been nothing but action.
Ronnie, medyo nagulat yata si Tore Campo with that late assault of Manny Pacquiao.
Yeah.
Tore Campo thought that he had the fight well in control. All of a sudden, ito si Pacquiao started dancing and connecting Muhammad Ali style.
They're really slugging it out. I mean, they're really throwing some big bombs, these two fighters.
And look at the way Manny Pacquiao is holding on to that right arm of Tore Campo. It looks like this youngster has learned a few tricks.
Oh, he missed with the left uppercut. Pacquiao going with the 1-2.
One thing about Pacquiao, he's steady with the combination.
And he's quick on his feet.
Yes. And what makes him, of course, even more dangerous is the fact that he likes to fight southpaw.
Oh! Watch the combination again by Pacquiao. You know, this is his best fight so far. I mean, he's met a classy opponent.
Yes. Well, he's showing tremendous confidence. He's striking with that right jab and then connecting with the left hook. Tore Campo sort of stopped in his tracks.
Pacquiao with a good combination again. Tore Campo is staggered. He hurt Tore Campo that time, Kinito.
Yes.
But Tore Campo is fighting back. It's nailed by Pacquiao.
And look at the way Pacquiao moves away from trouble. Good lateral movement on the part of Manny Pacquiao. Has a lot of moves for a young kid.
But this Tore Campo is really a gutsy fighter,
oh,
too.
Yes.
I mean, he's tough as they come.
Hindi din nagpapalamang ito si Rustico Terracampo. Notice the intelligence of Manny Pacquiao.
Oh, good combination against Pacquiao. Oh, another cracking combination by Pacquiao.
Almost out on his feet.
Pacquiao going after Terracampo. Cracking right. Another right by Terracampo, by Pacquiao. And Terracampo is trying to fight back, but he's getting nailed time and time again by Pacquiao.
A classic display of great craftsmanship here by Manny Pacquiao. He waits for Terracampo to miss, and then he moves in with his combinations. What perfect timing. Terracampo, rubbery leg. Manny Pacquiao taking his time and going for the kill. He's teaching Terracampo a lesson.
Using the right jab very, very effectively and putting the combination together nicely.
Oh, that left hook connected.
And a hard left. That time the heads clashed. And Pacquiao walking to the body and cracking him to the head. Oh. Terracampo trying to fight back. Another good right by Pacquiao. Terracampo in trouble, but they are exchanging big punches. There goes the bell, end of round number two. We're going to take a break. What a fight this is. Up next, our San Miguel Beer main event. Former world champion Rolando Pascua against Rafi Montalban. 12 rounds of boxing for the Junior Bantamweight Championship of the Philippines.
Ronnie, right, this appetizer we're covering can actually serve as a main event in itself.
You bet.
It is action-packed. Pacquiao versus Terracampo. And that's not all, folks. As Ronnie Nathaniel said, upcoming is the Philippine Junior Bantamweight title fight. Jojo Pascua, Rafi Montalban.
Round number three. Pacquiao in white, Terracampo in blue. Terracampo has carried the fight to Pacquiao.
Oh! Pacquiao!
He's out!
It's over. Oh my gosh!
It's over.
One punch. Manny Pacquiao cannot get up.
It's over.
Manny Pacquiao.
It's over.
Cannot get up on time.
It's over.
It's over. Manny Pacquiao. One punch and his eyes are crossed. His eyes are crossed. Terracampo.
That's
oh,
dangerous.
Coming out of nowhere. Manny Pacquiao. His eyes are crossed.
You know,
what a punch!
He caught him flush on the mouth.
Oh my gosh! Pacquiao was winning the fight handily, and he just took one punch, and his eyes crossed. Rustico Terracampo, we told you this guy's got a punch. Terracampo, you can never count out a puncher in a boxing bout. Manny Pacquiao falling to his first defeat. My gosh, what an upset. Manny Pacquiao is back on his feet. He didn't know what hit him. His eyes crossed. Just one punch.
Flash on the mouth. Now you see this. Okay.
Take a look at this.
Slow-mo, okay? And you're going to watch the left of Terracampo. He's going to catch him. He's going to walk into that left.
Just one punch. One punch. Flash on the jaw. Manny Pacquiao, you take a look at him there. No way he was going to beat that.
No way,
count.
No way.
Just one punch. And to think that back in round number two, I thought that Terracampo was going down.
Yes. He may have gone down, Kinito, if this boy didn't have to wear the heavier gloves.
Could be, yes.
Okay, you're going to see it in one more time, in slow-mo. Okay, tentative right by Pacquiao. Then you see he drops his right hand. Watch him, he dropped his right. You on. Aray!
It was a chin. It was a chin.
Yeah.
And he
and
got
look his glassy-eyed.
Yes. Glassy-eyed, and his eyes got crossed. And you know the point that you made, Ronnie, about the heavier gloves? I think you're so absolutely right. Because as I was mentioning before this fight began, when you're wearing heavier gloves, you lessen the impact of your blows. And despite the heavier gloves, Pacquiao managed to stagger Terracampo in round number two. And so if he fought with lighter gloves, Terracampo would have felt the full impact of the blows of Manny Pacquiao. And maybe Terracampo would have gone out like a light in round number two. But didn't happen that way. Maybe Pacquiao should... Maybe discipline himself a little bit more. If the fight is scheduled for or has a limit of 111 pounds, he's got to come in at that weight.
Well, the unbeaten streak of Manny Pacquiao is over, but our fight card is not over. We're going to take a break and come back with our main event in a moment.